نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله سلم بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم على خلفاء نبيك وأوصيائه وأهل بيته وعترته علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين وعلى المرأة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعلى سبطي نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهم السلام وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل مخرجه وجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه. عباد الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره. روي عن سيدنا ومولانا الإمام أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام أنه قال قوام الدين والدنيا بأربعة. The foundations of this life and the hereafter are based on four pillars, four stones. قوام الدين والدنيا. These four foundations are not just for the success in this life, but it is also for the success in the hereafter, in the next life. The first one, first foundation, عَالِمٌ مُسْتَعْمِلٌ عِلْمَهُ. A scholar that uses his knowledge to guide, to save, to educate, to reach out to people. If he does not use his knowledge to do these things, guidance, reaching out to others, teaching, educating, then he's not using his knowledge. He's wasting it. He has to carry this responsibility. Ulama, umana, ar-rusul. They have been left succeeding the anbiya. We don't have access to the anbiya. We don't see Ibrahim, we don't see Musa, we don't see Isa, we don't see the Prophet. We don't see the Imam. Who do you see? You see the scholar. The scholar is the one who transfers these ma'arif, these knowledges, these ulum, these manners to us. It is the scholar. So, عَالِمٌ مُسْتَعْمِلٌ عِلْمَهُ. Because there are some ulama, they don't use his knowledge, and some of them, as we see what Amir al-Mu'mineen says, they misuse it. عَالِمٌ مُسْتَعْمِلٌ عِلْمَهُ. Second foundation, وَجَاهِلٌ لَا يَسْتَنْكِفُ أَنْ يَتَعَلَّمُ. Someone who's not alim, he's a student, but he does not disdain to go and learn. He doesn't say, well, my social status, I'm rich, I am this, I am that, I am, let's say, 60 years old, 70 years old, I'm not still, you know, a little kid to go and learn. He doesn't say this. He says, yes, knowledge is useful for me at whatever age I am. It's better to be knowledgeable than being ignorant. At any age, even at the last day of our life, to die while we know is better than dying while we don't know. The story of the person who came to Imam al-Sadiq, he said, if I know one day has been left of my life, 24 hours. What should I do? Imam said, go, ta'allam. Ta'allam al-ilm. Go learn. One day is left of his life. To die while you know is better than to die while you don't know. So someone who's ready to learn, he says, I'm ready. If I can learn from this person, I go to him. If I learn from this school, I go to this school. If I learn in this city, I go to that city. If I go learn in this community, I go to this community. He doesn't disdain. لا يستنكف. وجاهل لا يستنكف أن يتعلم. Nothing should stop us from learning. Nothing. The other day I read in the paper that someone concluded, she concluded her PhD thesis at the age of 96 years old. She learned and learned until she got her PhD. She's a wise person. She did not waste her time going shopping and sitting with, you know, sipping tea with women and speaking about dunya and, you know. Really, she used her time in the best way, best manner. She left a legacy. Because this ilm that you leave behind, this is your legacy. إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمَ انْقَطَعَ أَمَلُهُ وَعَمَلُهُ إِلَّا عَنْ ثَلَاثٍ. First, ilmun yantafi'u bihi an-nas. If you leave a legacy, people come and learn. You are in your grave, you receive the credit. You receive the thawab, the reward. You are in your grave, you get the thawab. So don't say, I had knowledge enough for me because I'm not going to live longer than that. You would never say that. You know why? Because when it comes to money, we don't say, I have money enough for me, I'm not going to live. When it comes to money, we run after money. So why when it comes to ilm, we stop? We should not stop. This is number two. Number three, the third foundation, وَجَوَادٌ لَا يَبْخَلُ بِمَعْرُوفِهِ. A jawad, person who is rich and also what? Not only his pocket is rich, but his heart is rich too. Generous. Some people, the pocket is rich. Believe me. His pocket is rich, but when you look at his face, you feel sorry for him. Sometimes you need to give him $5, believe me. But he's rich, his pocket is rich, but the soul is not rich. Others, no. Others are the opposite. The pocket is empty, but the soul is rich. And the Quran says, يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ. Someone who's unaware, he thinks they are millionaires. But they are not millionaires. They have no dinner for tonight. But their soul is rich. They have honor. They have dignity. They have honor and dignity. This jawad, this person, the third example, is the one who gives. لا يبخل بمعروفه. He gives. When there is a need, he would rush to that need. Allah says to Sulaiman عليه السلام in Surah Sad, هذا عطاؤنا فن أو أمسك بغير حساب. This is our gift to you, يا Sulaiman. You are king. I'm giving you wealth. And when I give you wealth, I want you to give generously. فن without reckoning, without حساب. I want you, when you give graciously and generously. Don't say, I have given this 2 dinars, so the third one is too much for him. Give, because this is my money. Allah says, this is my money. Why do you worry about it? You are my agent. You have to give. فَمْنُن, give. When God has given you, share. Share. And number four foundation, وفقير لا يبيع آخرته بدنيا. Someone who's faqir. He doesn't have that good income. He has hard time making ends meet. He has hard time paying his rent, his food, his medication. But his soul is aziz, dignified. He does not sell himself cheap. He does not sell his akhirah, meaning he does not commit a sin. He knows there are ways of making money, but these ways are illegal. These ways are haram. He would not approach them. Though he need the money, but he says, the money that is haram, I don't touch it. Because I don't, لا يبيع آخرته بدنيا. I do not trade my akhirah for a few days in this life. I don't do that. Amir al-Mu'mineen says, فَإِذَا ضَيَّعَ الْعَالِمُ عِلْمَهُ. Once the scholar does not disseminate his knowledge, he wastes his knowledge. How does he waste his knowledge? He does not practice it. The ulama, how does they waste their knowledge? Sometimes they don't teach, sometimes they don't practice what they preach. This is how they lose their knowledge. فَإِذَا ضَيَّعَ الْعَالِمُ عِلْمَهِ اسْتَنْكَفَ الْجَاهِلُ أَنْ يَتَعَلَّمُ. Someone who is unaware and a student, he says, if the scholar is not practicing his knowledge, why should I go and learn? There is no benefit in me going and learning, because look at this scholar, he's alim, he's not practicing what he is learning. So we send wrong messages to the people, that ilm is useless, don't waste your time, when we don't practice it ourselves. وَإِذَا بَخِلَ الْغَنِيُّ بِمَعْرُوفِهِ. When someone is rich, but he does not give, بَاعَ الْفَقِيرُ آخِرَتَهُ بِدُنْيَاهِ. بَاعَ الْفَقِيرُ, someone who's faqir, poor, needy, he doesn't have income. In that case, when the rich one does not help him, he's going to go and sell himself cheap. He's going to go and commit haram. In some countries, these countries are very rich. They have surplus of wealth. Surplus, vast surplus of wealth. At the same time, you find some people begging in the streets. At the same time, you find some prostitutes in the hotels. Why should they have prostitutes? If the country takes care of its citizens and they lead a dignified life, there shouldn't be anyone who sells his honor or her honor, her dignity, cheap to others. When the economy is strong and the hakim is just, the ruler, the sultan is just, he takes care of his citizens, why should people go on and sell drugs and do this and do that? Go through illegal means. Because the hakim and those who are rich, they are not just. They are corrupt. They seize the wealth only for themselves. They don't share it with the citizens. فَإِذَا بَخِلَ الْغَنِيُّ بِمَعْرُوفِهِ بَاعَ الْفَقِيرُ آخرته بدنياه. صدق مولانا أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام.